a Google search on best text editor, we will see things like Notepad++, Sublime Text, and Atom, which are all newer graphical text editors. But we also see Vim, Emacs, and VI. Vim is just VI with improvements. So what is a text editor? Aren't programs like Microsoft Word and LibreOffice Writer text editors? Well, not exactly. Those programs are considered word processors. Word processors have more information than just the text file. They keep track of things like page size and title font properties and the like. And much of that is not kept in human-readable form. Text editors are more like Notepad on the Windows operating system. They're for files that are 100% human-readable, like computer programs. We are going to focus on the text editor Vim in this tutorial series, mainly because that's what I use where I work. I am using Linux Mint for this tutorial series, where a version of Vim is already installed. If you're using a Windows computer, Vim is available at no cost, but the file organization is a little bit different. I think Vim is installed on the Mac operating system, but I'm not sure about that. I do have a tutorial series that shows how to install and use Linux Mint if you are unfamiliar with Linux. You may want to view that before starting this video tutorial series. To open Vim on a Linux computer, I'll need to use the terminal. I'm going down to the menu and clicking on that. We see the terminals right here under System. We also have one here under the Favorites. And if we see all applications, I can go into System Tools, and there's a terminal right down here. We also have it down here on the panel. So it's used a lot in Linux. I'm going to click to open up a terminal. And to make the screen a little bigger, I'm going to hold down Control, Shift, and Plus. And here I'm at the command prompt. From here, to open up Vim, I'm going to type VI all by itself and press Enter. This tells us what version we're using. We're using 7.4.1689 of VI Improved, which is Vim. To get out of this, I'm going to hit the Escape key, then press the colon, Shift semicolon, and Q for quit. Now I'm back in my terminal. We'll see that the Escape key is used a lot in Vim. We're going to do a quick reminder of where we are when we open the terminal. And we're basically in the home folder. If I open up the home window using the graphical view, double clicking on that, we see desktop, documents, downloads, and more. To see that in our command line, I'm going to type ls. And here we see the same things. We've got our desktop, documents. To keep things simple for right now, we're just going to stick to this home directory. This wsconfig-sample.php, that is the sample WordPress file. It can be found by just doing a search on it on the internet. And that's what we're going to use in this first video. I want to use Vim to update that wsconfig-sample.php file. To do that, I'm going to type vi ws-con. And now I'm going to press Tab to use the autocomplete to type in the rest of that file name. Pressing Enter brings us into Vim. The first thing I'm going to do is press the J key. When I press J, it takes me down. When I press L, it takes me over to the right. Pressing K brings me up. And pressing H brings me over to the left. For most of us who are used to using word processors like Word or Writer, this is just crazy. And forget about using your mouse with Vim. It's almost useless. There are times when we can use it, but it is minimal. So how can something that is so different from what we're used to using be on this top lists of text editors? That is what we're going to look at in this entire tutorial series. For this video, we just want to make some simple edits to this configuration file. And we know that the J, L, K, and H keys move our cursor around. That's because Vim is a modal editor, meaning there are different modes. Currently, we are in what is called the normal mode. And pressing keys in this mode have different actions than when we're in other modes. I want to move down in this file, and I can get there by pressing the J key. I can also press the arrow down, but I'm using the J key. Here we see database name. I went a little low, so I'm going to go back up by pressing K. And now I'm going over to the right using my L key. And I'm at a point where we can change the database name. Right now, I'm going to press down the X key 8 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And we see the database is gone. That's because the X key deletes the character under the cursor. Now I'm going to press the letter I. This puts me in insert mode. From here, I can type in more. I'm going to type in WordPress DB. And to get rid of the extra characters, I'm going to press my delete key. Let's say something happened and we messed things up and we just want to quit out of this without saving anything. To do that, I'm going to press escape. That puts me back into normal mode. Now I'm going to press colon and Q for quit, just like we did earlier. When I press enter, it gives us an error. It's telling us that we made changes to this. If we really want to quit, we need to type Q and an exclamation point. Some people call this BAM. So I'm going to do this again. I'm going to press escape, colon, Q, and exclamation point, or BAM. Pressing enter, and I'm totally out. I have not saved anything, so I want to go back in, and I want to update that same database to say WordPress DB. I'm going to hit my arrow up, which will just bring back the last command I typed, and press enter. Now I'm going to press down the J key to take me down to DB name, holding down L, and now I'm going to use the X to get rid of the whole name. Now I'm going into insert mode, so I'm going to press I, and I'm going to type in WordPress DB. This is exactly how I want it. So this time I want to save my changes. So I'm going to hit the escape key again, press colon. This time I want to press the W. It's got to be a lowercase W and then the lowercase Q to quit. So write and then quit. Pressing enter saves my changes. If I want to view that again, I can go in and I see right down there at the bottom that we have our WordPress DB is saved just as we wanted it. So this time I want to quit again, pressing escape, colon, quit. We haven't made any changes, so quit should work without the exclamation point, and it does. In this video, we learned that Vim is a modal editor. We also used J, K, L, and H to move us around the screen, as well as X to get rid of characters in normal mode, and I to put us into insert mode from normal mode. We saw that we use the escape key to get back into normal mode when we are in insert mode and to give commands like when we want to quit. We pressed escape, colon, Q. In the next video, we're going to look at updating Vim so we can get the most out of it.